Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Let us rejoice and exult for joy, for the Lord of all has shown his love for a holy and glorious virgin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we commemorate today Saint Agatha, a young woman who offered herself and her life for Christ our Savior. And so in this Eucharistic celebration, we pray that we too may always choose goodness over evil, choose love over hate. And so as we begin this celebration, let us first acknowledge our sins and humbly ask the Lord for his pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the Virgin Martyr, Saint Agatha, implore your compassion for us, O Lord, we pray, for she found favor with you by the courage of her martyrdom and the merit of her chastity. through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Let brotherly love continue. Do not neglect hospitality, for through it some have unknowingly entertained angels. Be mindful of prisoners as if sharing their imprisonment, and of all the ill-treated as of yourselves, for you also are in the body. Let marriage be honored among all, and the marriage bed be kept undefiled. For God will judge the immoral and adulterers. Let your life be free from love of money, but be content with what you have. For he has said, I will never forsake you or abandon you. Thus we may say in confidence, the Lord is my helper, and I will not be afraid. What can anyone do to me? Remember your leaders who spoke the word of God to you. Consider the outcome of their way of life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Through an army encamped against me, my heart will not fear. The war be waged upon me, even then will I trust.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
For he will hide me in his abode in the day of trouble. He will conceal me in the shelter of his tent. He will set me high upon a rock.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. Do not be in anger. Repel your servant. You are my helper. Cast me not off.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Please stand.
Blessed are they who have kept the word with a generous heart and yield the harvest through perseverance.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
King Herod heard about Jesus, for his fame had become widespread, and people were saying, John the Baptist has been raised from the dead. That is why mighty powers are at work in him. Others were saying he is Elijah, still others he is a prophet like any of the prophets. But when Herod learned of it, he said, it is John whom I beheaded. He has been raised up. Herod was the one who had John arrested and bound in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip, whom he had married. John had said to Herod, "It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife." Herodias harbored a grudge against him and wanted to kill him, but was unable to do so. Herod feared John, knowing him to be a righteous and holy man, and kept him in custody. When he heard him speak, he was very much perplexed, yet he liked to listen to him. Herodias had an opportunity one day when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers, his military officers, and the leading men of Galilee. His own daughter came in and performed a dance that delighted Herod and his guests. The king said to the girl, "Ask of me whatever you wish, and I will grant it to you." He even swore many things to her. "I will grant you whatever you ask of me, even to half of my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What shall I ask for?" Her mother replied, "The head of John the Baptist." The girl hurried back to the king's presence and made her request, "I want you to give me at once on a platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was deeply distressed, but because of his oath and the guests, he did not wish to break his word to her. So he promptly dispatched an executioner with orders to bring back his head. He went off and beheaded him in the prison. He brought in the head on a platter and gave it to the girl. The girl, in turn, gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we commemorate Saint Agatha. The name of Saint Agatha means good in Greek. Agatha means good. Ang ibig sabihin po ng kanyang pangalan ay mabuti. And I think the significance of her name tells us also of the significance of her choice in life. She always chose the good. She always chose goodness over bad and evil. Ang pinipili niya palagi ay ang kabutihan at hindi ang kasamaan. And my dear brothers and sisters, I think today this is the message of her life, of her martyrdom to all of us. Always choose the good. And that is also what we heard in our gospel today, of how John the Baptist, in spite of being threatened to be executed, chose not the evil, but chose the good. And my dear brothers and sisters, why do we choose goodness over evil? Bakit kaya ang pipiliin natin ay ang kabutihan kaysa kasamaan? Alam niyo po sa mga kabataan ngayon, baka sa mga nakikinig sa atin online, nauuso po ngayon yung kasabihan na kapag ikaw ay pumili ng mabuti, meron kang plus point sa langit. Baka naririnig yan ng mga kabataan ngayon. At kapag gumawa ka ng masama, naku, minus points ka sa langit. But my dear brothers and sisters, this is not why we choose goodness. It is not about choosing goodness because I need some points for heaven, or my points will be decreased because if I choose bad, I will be having less points. It is not about earning points in heaven. But according to our first reading today from the letter to the Hebrews, choosing good is about choosing love. Loving one another begets goodness. Kapag tayo po ay pumipili, gumawa ng kabutihan at hindi kasamaan, ipinapakita nito na mayroong pagmamahal at pag-ibig. According to our first reading today, let brotherly love continue. If you have hospitality and you welcome people, then it shows you love other people. If you are mindful of prisoners, according to our first reading, then you are mindful of those who are ill-treated. If you are faithful to your husband, if you are faithful to your wife, if you are faithful in marriage, it does not mean that you have plus points in heaven. It means that you love your husband, you love your wife. My dear brothers and sisters, if we choose goodness, then it means there is love in your heart. But if we choose evil, then we must think again if we still have love of God in our hearts. My dear brothers and sisters, we commemorate Saint Agatha, who chose not to deny Christ and in turn sacrifice her life. That is the choice of goodness. John the Baptist chose to love in spite of being threatened with execution because he chose goodness. He chose love over evil. Sana po ngayong araw, piliin po ninyo kung ano ang mabuti at tanggihan ang kasamaan. I pray that in this Eucharistic celebration, we are reminded by Jesus to say yes to God, say no to evil, say yes to goodness, say no to wrongdoings. All of these we are doing because of love of God and of love of neighbor. Piliin ang kabutihan, tanggihan ng kasamaan, sapagkat ito ay nagmumula sa pagmamahal natin sa Diyos at sa kapwa. Amen.
Please stand.
Our struggle against the forces of evil will be successful if we unite ourselves in prayer. Let us now pray to the God of truth as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the church, like Saint John, may become courageous proclaimers of the gospel of truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may give wholehearted support to the church's struggle against those dark forces that enslave men to violence and crime. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as Christians, we may be vocal in our concern against those who exploit and for those who are exploited through political pressure and corrupt practices. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are victims of oppression may finally gain justice, freedom, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffered and died in faith may gain their heavenly reward. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your love for us never changes or fades away. Give us the courage to walk in your presence all the days of our life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the offerings we bring in celebration of Blessed Agatha win your gracious acceptance, O Lord, we pray, just as the struggle of her suffering and passion was pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr Agatha, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness, through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Agatha, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
brothers and sisters, the body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray. O God, who bestowed on Blessed Agatha a crown among the saints for her twofold triumph of virginity and martyrdom, grant, we pray, through the power of this sacrament, that bravely overcoming every evil, we may attain the glory of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tomorrow, Saturday, we will be having the launching or opening Mass for the celebration of the 500 years of Christianity in the Philippines here in the Archdiocese of Manila. The opening Mass will be celebrated by our Apostolic Administrator, Bishop Broderick Pabilio, concelebrated by priests of the Archdiocese. You may follow our celebration of the Mass online at 9 a.m. here at the Manila Cathedral Facebook page, also on our YouTube channel. So tomorrow is a great day because we are formally launching the celebrations of the 500 years in the Archdiocese of Manila. We hope that you will follow the Mass and also all the activities this year for our commemoration of this milestone in the story of our faith as Filipinos, as Christians, as Catholics. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.